फाइंड क्यूब रूट ऑफ 4 2 8 7 5। टू फाइंड द क्यूब रूट फर्स्ट वी शुड डू द प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ इट। सो लेट अस डू दैट इज 4 2 8 7 5। Now, for this number, last digit is 5. So we take 5 here. Now, first number is 4, 4 smaller than 5. So we take two numbers, that is 42. Now, a number close to 42 in 5 table is 5 8s 40. 42 minus 40 is 2, 2 carried forward, making it 28. Now, a number close to 28 in 5 table is 5 5s 25. 28 minus 25 is 3, 3 carried forward, making it 37. Now a number close to 37 in 5 table is 5 7s 35. 37 minus 35 is 2, 2 carried forward, making it 25. Now when do we get 25 in 5 table? 5 5 is 25. Now for this number, last digit is 5, so we take 5 here. First number is 8. A number close to 8 in 5 table is 5 1's 5. 8 minus 5 is 3, 3 carried forward, making it 35. When do we get 35 in 5 table? 5 7's 35. Next number is 7. A number close to 7 in 5 table is 5 1's 5. 7 minus 5 is 2, 2 carried forward, making it 25. When do we get 25 in 5 table? 5 5 is 25. Now for this number, last digit is 5. So we take 5 here. Now first number is 1, 1 smaller than 5. So we take two numbers, that is 17. A number close to 17 in 5 table is 5 3 is 15. 17 minus 15 is 2, 2 carried forward, making it 21. A number close to 21 in 5 table is 5 4 is 20. 21 minus 20 is 1, 1 carried forward, making it 15. When do we get 15 in 5 table? 5 3 is 15. Okay, next. For this number, last digit is 3, which is not even. So this is not divisible by 2. Next prime number is 3. To check divisibility by 3, for that we should add the digits. That is 3 plus 4 plus 3. We get 10. Is 10 divisible by 3? No. So this number also not divisible by 3. Next prime number is 5. The last digit is neither 0 nor 5. So this is not divisible by 5. Next prime number is 7. To check divisibility by 7, we check in this way. 343 by 7. Here we have 34. A number close to 34 in 7 table is 7 4 is 28. 34 minus 28 is 6, 6 carried forward, making it 63. 7 9 63. So this is divisible by 7. 7 49 times is this number. Next. 49 is nothing but 7 7's 49. Now 7 is a prime number, so we take 7 1's 7. So now 4 2 8 7 5 is equal to the product of these numbers, that is C. 5 into 5 into 5 into 7 into 7 into 7. Now we have to find the cube root. So you take cube root on both sides. Next, we have a property for the cube root, that is any number that is present 3 times inside the cube root, that number will come out of the cube root and it will be written only once. What I mean is, see, here the number 5 is present 3 times inside the cube root. So it will be coming out and it will be written only once. Next, here we have the number 7 present 3 times inside the cube root. So it will be coming out and it will be written only once. No more numbers are left in the cube root. So we are left with 5 into 7, that is 35. And on this side we have cube root 42875. So cube root of this equal to 35. This is our answer. Am I clear?